Hello everyone, I'm Lucy Gunawan, the head of the data science practice at TIMi. Welcome to the second video in our tutorial series about the integration between Anatella and Azure. In the previous video, we created and configured a new app inside the Azure portal. Now, it's time to put it to use. In this video, I'll guide you through the process of getting your first Anatella Unlock Key to get access to all Azure services and data directly from Anatella. If you already have an Anatella Unlock Key, but it has expired, you're also in the right place. Simply follow the procedure explained here to get your new Anatella Unlock Key. Anatella has many connectors and functionalities to connect to Azure services. Here are some of the connectors that you can use. All these boxes require the same two parameters, the Azure Application ID and the Anatella Unlock Key. The process of obtaining the Azure Application ID is covered in the initial stage, which you can find detailed in the previous video titled Anatella First Time Setup to Access Azure App Registration in this series. Before you proceed with this tutorial, kindly ensure that the initial stage has been completed. Let's now see how to get your personal Anatella Unlock Key. To obtain this key, you need three crucial parameters provided by your administrator: the Azure Application ID, the Azure Tenant ID, and the Azure Client Secret. If you're unsure about the procedure for obtaining these three parameters, you can refer back to the previous videos in this series. Click here to watch this video again. You also need your own personal login credential for Azure as a regular user. To acquire your Anatella Unlock Key, follow these simple steps. Open Anatella and add Azure Unlock Box to your workflow graph. Then access the properties of this action. Within the Azure Unlock Box, input the corresponding parameters, the Azure Application ID, Azure Tenant ID, and Azure Client Secret. You got these three parameters inside the previous video. Again, the link to the previous video is here. Now, depending on the grants that was given to the Azure app, you need to uncheck some of the little boxes here. In the previous video, we enable all services, so I'll keep all the little checkboxes checked. Let's execute the Azure Unlock box. When you run this action, your internet browser opens. Please sign in to the account that holds the Azure data that you want to manage. It's important to note that you should not use the credential of the Azure administrator who created the app in the Azure. Instead, use your own personal credential here. Once signed in, click on Accept. So, this action concludes by presenting your Anatella Unlock Key with a successful confirmation. My practice typically involves reinserting this key information directly into the Azure Unlock box itself. Feel free to copy the key and paste it in the placeholder for notes field. And of course, make sure to save the Anatella file, naming it something descriptive like azure_unlock.anatella. This approach offers three distinct advantages. First, reference for future use. The azure_unlock.anatella file serves as an accessible reference point whenever you require connectivity to Azure services. By keeping the key here, you enable yourself to reuse it conveniently whenever the need arises. Second, renewal convenience. If the key expires, you can conveniently reuse your small Anatella graph to renew your access and get a new unlock key. Third, sharing with colleagues. You can share this box with your colleagues after ensuring your safe unlock key is removed, of course. This allows your colleague to effortlessly obtain their personal Anatella unlock key by running the process anew within the same three parameters that you have. There might be instances where, instead encountering the success page as displayed above, you come across an error message like "fail at step 2," followed by series of seemingly random characters. Here's the thing, no need to worry. This occurrence is generally attributed to Azure taking its time. Your newly configured application settings required a bit of time to propagate. So give it a few minutes and then run the Anatella unlock box again. At some point, it will give you the required Anatella unlock key. And that's the essence of it. You now possess two pivotal elements essential for the seamless connection to any Azure services within Anatella, the Azure application ID and the Anatella unlock key. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. If you have any question or need further clarification on any of the topics covered today, feel free to leave your comment down below. We highly value your feedback. And if you found this video helpful, don't hesitate to give it a thumbs up. Your support truly means a lot to us. If you're interested in more tutorials, engaging discussion, and useful tips, consider subscribing to our channel. By doing so, you'll stay informed and won't miss out on our upcoming content. I now invite you to click here to watch the next video in this series about the integration between Anatella and Azure. In this third video, we'll access data stored inside SharePoint. With just a few mouse clicks, we'll read files from SharePoint and write files to SharePoint. Cool! See you next time!